High School Athletic Association proudly presents another championship event. Your network sponsors are Milk Promotion Services of Indiana, your Indiana dairy farmer, Farm Bureau Insurance, and the nearly 700 Farm Bureau Insurance agents located throughout the state. And Indiana Bell, a member of the Ameritech family of companies, helping you communicate.
Tonight, there are only two places in the state of Indiana to be. One is right where you are, comfortably settled in right in front of your television set, and the other is where we are, at Market Square Arena in Indianapolis, site of the 78th IHSAA Boys State Finals Basketball Tournament. From an original field of 388, the teams have dwindled down to a precious few. In this case, two. The Muncie Central Bearcats of Bill Harrell, now 27-1, and the still undefeated Minutemen of Concord High at 28-0 with Jim Hahn in command. Well, the first time in the history of the state high school basketball tournament in Indiana, the numbers one and two teams in the state will clash. Muncie Central's Bearcats earlier today defeated the People's Choice, Bedford North Lawrence, 60-53. Chandler Thompson ran wild, 32 points and 13 rebounds. They've won seven state championships. Might this be eight? We'll find out shortly. Concord defeated Hammond Bishop Knowles 66-50 today in a ball game that was closer than that through the first three quarters. Sean Kemp, 19 points, 15 boards, and 9 block shot. He is a horse. Only 6 undefeated teams have ever won the state championship, and tonight Concord would like to become number 7. I'll be joined tonight with Hilliard Gates and Tom Heschen, and we'll be back to meet the starting lineups and get this championship game underway in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. The Bearcats got here tonight. They won the Muncie Central sectional, as you can see, and in resounding fashion. Enrolled into Newcastle and knocked off Newcastle and Greenfield. Never an easy task on that court. Then onto the semi-state at Hinkle Fieldhouse here in Indianapolis last week with wins over Bloomington South and Ben Davis, and then that win over Bedford North Lawrence earlier today. We'll take a look in a few minutes at the Concord Trail, how they got here. That's how the Concord Minutemen got here tonight for this title game. They won the Elkhart sectional. That's where Concord is located, by the way, in the Elkhart area. Northwood, Elkhart Central, and Penn. And they won the regional on that same floor, beating Tippecanoe Valley and East Noble. Then had a battle of their lives last week in the Fort Wayne semi-state, beating Dwenger and Norwell. Concord just now arriving back on the floor here at Market Square Arena. And already out there, the Muncie Central Bearcats. And a state title game with the Bearcats at 27-1 and Concord 28-0. Winners over Hammond Bishop Knowles 66-50. Muncie Central knocked off Bedford North Lawrence 60-53. It's time to meet the participants in tonight's game. Once again, Scott Gray.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Indianapolis at Market Square Arena for the championship game of the 78th Indiana High School Athletic Association Boys State Basketball Tournament. Here are the starting lineups for tonight's championship game. First, for the visiting team, the Concord Minutemen. Starting at one guard, a 5'10", 150-pound sophomore, number 22, Jamar Johnson. At the other guard, a 6-foot, 172-pound senior, number 24, Steve Larkin. At one forward, a 6-foot, 11-inch, 230-pound senior, number 40, Sean Kemp. At the other forward, a 6'2", 175-pound senior, number 44, Maceo Sharp. And the center, a 6'2", 182-pound sophomore, number 54, Bill Mutch. The head coach of the 28-0 Concord Minutemen, Jim Hahn. And now the starting lineup for the home team, the Muncie Central Bearcats. At one guard, a 6'3", 175-pound senior, number 30, Chandler Thompson. At the other guard, a 6'1", 160-pound junior, number 34, Chris Winningham. At one forward, a 5'10", 180-pound senior, number 15, Vic Young. At the other forward, a 6'4", 170-pound senior, number 40, Sam Long. And the center, a 6'1", 170-pound senior, number 12, Billy Vance. The head coach of the 27-1 Muncie Central Bearcats, Bill Harrell.
We'll go for the title in just 1 minute. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell. Tom, here are the teams match up statistically.
Well, you see one big statistic there, and that is the fact that the opponents are not shooting very well from the field against Concord, 38.2%. Everything else, not too much to make do of right there. There's the rebounding. And the points per game. The Bearcats about 10 more points per game on the average. There are the positions. The center spot being the only significant one there, if that's significant. And the officials on the left, Mark Massaro from Kokomo. And on the right, Roger DeYoung from Hebron, and we're ready to go.
This is Jerry Baker, along with Tom Heshen and Hildyard Gates. We are most happy to have you here. 59th consecutive year, they've had a sellout for the Boys State High School Basketball Championship, and you've got a front row seat. Concord in green, the Bearcats in white, and Muncie controls the tip, gets it up court in a hurry to Sam Long. Oh, you'd love to start a game like that. That is much in contrast to how Muncie Central began the day at 11 o'clock this morning when they were down 8-0 in the first couple of minutes against Bedford North Lawrence and came back to win it by 7, 60-53. If you're just joining us, keep an eye on number 40 in green. That's Sean Kemp. He's 6'11". He's got the ball, and he plays outside.
Well, he shows you that he can shoot it from any place. A 1-3-1 zone, really, is what the Bearcats opened with here. And we'll see how they vary that throughout the evening.
Sean Kemp is headed to the University of Kentucky. They could use him almost anywhere down there because this flat, looks like this flat go anywhere on the court. Sam Long. Sam was 1-for-10.
Yeah, he struggled to get 2 points this afternoon, and it came late in the ballgame, and he has their first two baskets tonight.
He's 2 out of 2, and it's 4-2 after being tied. There's the three-pointer that is short. The rebound by Kemp puts it back up. He won't get this one, and white shirts from everywhere, and Sam Long is amongst them. Long must have watched the videotapes of this afternoon's game and thought, wait a minute, that's not me. Here is the guy that was really tough today, Chandler Thompson. The ball is batted three and chased down by Muncie Central, and he stepped on the baseline. Good strong effort down there by Billy Vance. Interesting. How does Billy Vance start at center, Tom Heshen?
He got 15 points this afternoon. That means you can start anywhere.
Anywhere you want to. It's Bill Harrell's five guys. He may give you five forwards or five guards or five centers. He's just got five guys out there.
That's right. He's going to play with five.
Now, he hasn't found a way to play with six or four, for that matter, but he's an interesting man. We'll talk more about him as the game progresses. Concord down 4-2, a minute and a half into the ball game. Rebound comes long, but it's chased down over here by Maceo Sharp. They gave Mutch some freedom in the middle, and he turned it, took the shot and missed it, and the rebound comes down on that baseline. And the second opportunity is this time
right. They had a lot of opportunities there, and the Bearcats couldn't get the ball off the board. A lot of good athletes for Concord, obviously, an undefeated club, and they finally got it to drop.
Deflected, picked up by Thompson. He lost it. Out comes Concord again. Sean Kemp leads the break and underhands it for crying out loud, and it rims out of there. And a foul from behind on Maceo Sharp. This is the first time, Tom, that I've had a chance today, earlier today, to watch Kemp. You and I chatted before the game. The thing I'm most impressed about, Hillary, you've seen him, is he's more than just a big 6'11 guy. He can flat do things.
Well, he's a good athlete. Winningham's interesting right here, how he's going to try and slow it down. He more or less stayed out of the way, and as it turned out, that was a nice thing to do. They drew the foul.
Five ball game at four, second time it's been tied. Victor Young may have traveled, and he did. Muncie Central's lone loss, in case you're wondering, was to a ball club that many thought might be here today, the Richmond Red Devils, 67-61 in overtime. They've had 12 wins over 20 points, 4 over 30, and they won two of their ball games by over 40 points. Well, they got a backdoor break that time, and the shot went in and came back out of there for Steve Larkin.
Well, Muncie doing what I thought they would. They're going to bring it down quickly.
Chandler Thompson rebounds and scores. Thompson getting his first two off the miss by Sam Long.
They're going to set the half-court offense if they can't get the good break, but they're going to take the ball into the offensive court very quickly.
Keep in mind that Muncie Central, this is the second ball game for both these clubs today. They had about 2 more hours. Great pass from Mutz to Sean Kemp. There is not a defensive player in the country at any level that can stop that shot.
Well, that's not your normal high school play.
Tie ball game at six. Rebound, Chandler Thompson puts it back up and scores. It took Thompson, what, Tom, about a half a quarter to finally get on track, almost a full quarter earlier today.
Well, the Bearcat offense in the first quarter this morning really sputtered, but from that point on, they seemed very effective, and they started that way tonight.
Taken inside and stripped away by Chandler Thompson, who tossed it back out to keep from stepping on the baseline, and Mutch got it. Clears off on the near side, and Jamar Johnson. Now Larkin. Larkin and Johnson are the guards. Bill Mutch in the middle. Oh, Sean Kemp's third bucket. This time we'll do it backwards and a walking violation after the shock repercussions of that thing. My goodness.
I'll tell you, it looks as though Bill has a little different defense here tonight. Thompson and Long are kind of straggling in the free throw lane. They're not really going out after anyone. And they're playing right in there, but the ball comes out to the point. One of them has to step up, and they've done that, and then throw in the alley-oop.
Good play that time by Victor Young, and a good play as they go the other way by Steve Larkin. So turnovers at both ends. Larkin missing, and here comes Kemp. He couldn't get it, but somehow Concord comes out of there with it. We're halfway through the first quarter, and it's an 8-8 ball game.
And another phenomenal play. You can watch basketball a lot of years and never see anything like that.
I am absolutely astounded at this guy, and that's what else he does. He completely destroys your game plan, at least for the next time up the floor. Sean Kemp has done about everything there is for a guy to do. In fact, he needs 6 points to pass Steve Alford into the number 9 scorer in the career scoring list in the state. He's already got 8 of them.
Well, the Bearcats have turned it over 5 times already, as you've seen right there on your screen. Maybe we'll get to it in just a moment.
Inbounds pass to Mutch, deep in that corner. Mutch trying to work the baseline, fires across to the other side, and a walking violation call that time on Concord.
I'm going to say neither team's going to come out here and play scared. It looked as though the Bearcats were going to take it right at Kemp down here early with Sam Long. Let him go in there. And Jim Hahn is just as determined. We're going to take the ball to our big man, and you're going to have to stop us inside.
Kemp became the 18th player in Indiana State history to score 2,000 points.
Good move by Long that time, just as we said. He's taking it right at Kemp. Kemp didn't really make a move to slow him down.
He is 3 out of 5 from the floor after going 1 for 10 this afternoon. That lob goes into the photographers at the end of the floor. We mentioned that Kemp needed 6 to pass Steve into the number 9 spot of the career scoring list, and that's an all-star list of names also. So he has firmly entrenched himself in Indiana basketball history. Here's an offensive foul. Oh, wait a minute.
Well, we've got one each way. Got a block and a gonna have a jump ball.
We got two officials with contrasting calls here. The outside official called a charge, the inside official called a block.
Now they're gonna walk over to the score bench and talk it over and let the scorekeeper know exactly. Mark Massariu, the underneath official, had the block, and Roger DeYoung outside indicated an offensive foul.
We got a note handed to us here that Sean Kemp has a touch of the flu today. Well, I hate to see him when he's healthy, though, for crying out loud, Hilliard.
That's not spelled F-L-E-W, is it?
Oh, man.
No, they're going to make it a foul on Victor Young. I think the foul was called offensively before he got to the next man that was whistled for the block.
Well, they call one on Victor Young also. Do they call a double foul? They called a double foul.
Foul on the possession changes. That's right.
All right, so Young gets one, and Larkin gets one.
Concord is doing a lot of offensive rebounding.
Yeah, they're not just a one-man gang. Kemp creates a lot of stuff. There he is right there, and a great play by Chandler Thompson.
And Sean Kemp has not had many of his shots blocked over the course of the season.
Sean Kemp blocked 9 today. He's at 133 on the year, and timeout with 2:39 to play. We're right back where we started. Muncie Central and Concord are tied at 10. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana.
Well, we're going to see Maceo Sharp with a basketball right there. As you note, the score is tied. Get the ball out to Much in front, and here he very nicely puts it right up on the rim for Kemp to finish it off. There's another turnaround right here we just had that Chandler Thompson took care of for him.
Kemp is averaging 5 blocks a game. He had 9 in the win over Hammond Bishop Dole today. There's a shooting in the ball game so far.
Concord with 4 more field goal attempts.
Five ball game at 10. Here are the rebound numbers. No significant difference there. Five ball game at 10. It's the fourth time it's been tied. Actually, the fifth time it's been tied. They tied it at 8 also. So 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Here's the steal by Mudge. Here's the lead to Kemp and taken away. And Kemp got it back and can't get it. And the rebound by Chandler Thompson. Understand that Chandler Thompson is 6'3 and Kemp is 6'11. In a flat-out jumping contest, you wouldn't want to put a whole lot of money on either one of these guys because they are about as equal as you can get despite the size differential. Victor Young lobs it across on the far side to Billy Vance. Vance came off the bench in the win over Bedford North Lawrence and played a sensational ball game today. Sam Long, he has 8 points in the period. He has 8 of the 12 showing on the scoreboard right now.
Well, they tried to get him a part of that offense this afternoon. He just couldn't get the shots to drop, but he's certainly come back tonight shooting very well. There's a slap by Billy Vance knocking it away from Johnson, and Concord retains the possession.
Each club has led, but never by more than 2 points in this first period with a minute 39 to play. And a whistle down on the baseline. And the foul away from the ball will go on Jamar Johnson.
And Johnson's trying to set a pick. They're going to run Kemp around the pick and underneath and maybe lob that ball up from the point. But Johnson there, fine sophomore performer. Whistled for the foul.
Concord Minutemen. Muncie Central Bearcats. Good fake by Victor Young. Long again. Well, Sam is having the kind of an evening that he had in a negative kind of an afternoon. He has 10 points, 10 of the 14, the biggest lead of the day for the Muncie Central Bearcats at 4. And Sean Kemp takes care of 2 of those at his 10th point of the game.
Hey, those kind of efforts will help your shooting percentage, and the team percent goes right up with it.
Another great baseline move by Sam Long. I think Bill Harrell wanted him to play for one shot. He was up off the bench yelling.
That was a pretty good shot.
Yes, pretty good if you're going to take one. That's the one to take right there. It is, of course, a sellout crowd and a loud crowd. And there is a foul on the baseline prior to the attempted shot by Sean Kemp.
Yeah, I think Winningham's going to be whistled for stepping in. Let's see. No, it's not Winningham. It's going to be Sam Long.
First on Sam. You'll see Bill Harrell to the left of your screen. Won three state championships, one in Kentucky, down at Shelby County in 66, and he won back-to-back titles with these Bearcats in 78 and 79. Much missing. And Kemp almost tore the rim off and missed the slam. Final 30 seconds and a steal at the other end.
But they got a break. They're going to call a kick.
All right, so the Bearcats will get the ball and keep possession. Now we'll see if they go for the final shot. That's what Bill wants. There is Jim Hahn, 31-year-old head coach of Concord's Minutemen. In his fifth year there with a record of 89 and 34. That's actually now 90 and 34. He's won 73% of his games there. Final 20 seconds of the first quarter.
Now let's see who's going to take this one. Sam says, let's start cranking her up. And Sam's the hot man. He has it right now.
He got himself in trouble. Now goes inside, and Kemp got a piece of it. He got it back, turns to the 14th foot, and scores! Sam Long with an outstanding first period. And a six-point lead is the biggest for either ball club. Bearcats lead the Minutemen after one. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
Do you mail your insurance premiums to Wall Street or keep them at home on Main Street? When you race.
With Hilliard Gates and Tom Hessian, this is Jerry Baker, and this is the Sam Long, Sean Kemp show. Watch Long. He's having a sensational ball game. He's got 14 of the 18 Muncie Central points in the first quarter. And there's the final two that he got. Sean Kemp has 10 of the 12 Concord has on the boards, and Muncie Central will get the basketball to begin the second period.
Four players have done all the scoring in the game.
Chandler Thompson has the other four for Muncie Central, and Jamar Johnson has the other two for Concord. Winningham, Long, rebound pulled off by Concord. Muncie Central is a school of 1,242 kids. Concord, 1,175. Not a very large discrepancy there as far as attendance is concerned. Just underway, second period. Baseline shot is good by Maceo Sharp. Maceo becomes the third Concord player to score with his first 2 points of the game.
Now he's not going to take many shots, but he had the room and made a good effort there. Here's the defense we saw late in the game against Bishop Knoll this afternoon. Ball off Chandler Thompson's foot. Turned it over. They were very successful. It's kind of a 1-2-2 press on the half court. They don't extend themselves beyond the center line. 5 of 10 and 5 baskets, obviously, 10 points for Kemp.
And the total distance is about 25 feet because the first one was 24. Not quite 24. It's only a two-pointer. Reach-in foul from behind on Jamar Johnson.
Well, those are kind of the fouls that make you scratch your head a little bit if you're Jimmy Hahn over there. Johnson tried to reach in. Sam has hit 7 of 11 from the field. That's pretty good shooting in anybody's league.
Head coach Jim Hahn. School winning its second regional title, the other back in 86, their first ever semi-state. Won three sectionals in his half a dozen years there, 5 years there. Steal by Concord again. Concord's got some good ball handlers. They run a very deliberate offense when it's available to them, and a lot of it centered on this guy right here. A lot of stuff seems to happen to Tadlib, and at the same time, there's always something that's being picked or screened out there. A great defensive play turned in by Victor Young. To Winningham, they try to go up court to Thompson, and it's out of bounds to Concord again.
Well, they're trying their best to get down the court and get that break in order not to have to go against the set defense with the big man in the middle rejecting those shots, and as a result, they've committed a few errors in doing it.
6.5 minutes to go on the first half of this basketball game. Well, the state title in the state of Indiana. Good defensive play by Thompson, who got a piece of it, and Long yanks it out of there.
You know, that's the second time they've seen that today. It looks as though he's far enough off of you that there's no way he's going to block that shot. And Sharp thought he had a nice baseline jumper, and it turned out to be the man was right in his face.
Thompson almost pulled off a magical shot. He doesn't get it done, and Sam Long is right at it again.
That's a tremendous effort right there by Sam Long. He had to wrestle the ball away. got the ball where he could use the board and kind of reversed it up there off the right hand. Samazdal 8 for 12 from the field. Ball deflected on. Another great save by Muncie Central. I believe it was Vance up to Winningham, and Winningham is fouled prior to the shot. Billy Vance, who came off the bench to play exceptionally well in the afternoon ball game, picking up 15 points and 6 rebounds. Let's see if that's not him. Number 12 on your screen. Watch this effort. Well, he's up in the air, and he knows, let's go to the offensive end with it, and he gets it up to Winningham. Now, Bill Mutch is going to catch him, and Bill, we see right there, it's very clearly a foul, and Winningham's going to be at the line.
That is the number one foul on Bill Mutch. Nobody in serious foul at the call this early in the contest. Winningham, Tom Heschen, had no points, no rebounds, 0 for 1 from the field, 0 for 1 from the free throw line. If I said to you, did he have a good ball game, you'd say no, but that's not true.
No, he had the defensive honors this afternoon of going after Damon Bailey. He did that quite well. Bailey got 25 points, but hit only 8 of 20 from the field. And Winningham's a hard-nosed competitive kid. Now the Bearcats are back in a real 2-3 zone this time.
They got a 7-point lead, which is as large as it has been so far in this contest, with 5 minutes and 22 seconds to play in this first half. And again, Thompson gets over there so quickly. Rebounded by Sam Long. Looked for the outlet pass. They had a man breaking it for Winningham. Couldn't get it there. They go the other way this time to Billy Vance. Tapped in the sky by Long. Lost it. Foul called. Nope, walking. That time, simply too many bodies in the same shirt color in the same area. Victor Young got in there, and Sam Long was in the same general area, and they turned the ball over.
Long at 6'4 is showing you that he's not a bad jumper either. He was right up there that time to get the ball away from Kemp.
3 minutes gone in the second quarter. Score is 21-14. The Muncie Central Bearcats lead the Concord Minutemen. Mutch inside may have walked it. Yes. Bill Mutch, the 6'2 sophomore. He started 6'2 center and a 6'11 forward.
Mutch thought he was going to have the defender right up on him, and he was going to spin off of him, and when he did, he saw the little space there and took the step.
Chandler Thompson. And a whistle, and we've got a technical foul being called for hanging on the rim, and I believe it'll be on Sean Kemp.
It's going to be on Thompson.
Oh, is it on Thompson? All right. We'll take a look at it again here. They're both up so high.
Slide.
Yep.
All four hands are right up there, all over the rim of the basket.
Well, the fans boo, but that's not really the kind of a call you make a decision on here. It's in the rule book that way.
Well, the replay showed it clearly.
Yeah. Jamar Johnson, who's the top free throw shooter on the ball club at 81%, missing the first one. He has 3 points. That is Bill Harrell, 58-year-old head coach of the Muncie Central Bearcats, graduated from Belfry High School in Kentucky, and then a Bachelor of Arts degree from Kentucky Wesleyan and a Master's degree at the University of Kentucky. 4:37 to play in this first half, 21-15 ball game, with Muncie Central out in front. John Kemp from way outside. Rebound by Chandler Thompson. Well, there's a matchup.
Yeah.
Thompson and Kemp. 4:13 to play in the half. Almost a steal. Billy Vance got in traffic and double dribbled.
A lot more turnovers around the basket here this evening than we normally would see, but it's the fact that the play is so intense in there and there are such jumpers that the players sense that, and they're really trying to get good control of the ball with their body to protect that ball, and sometimes difficult.
Normally, Tom, by this time of the game, things have settled down a bit. That's not the case here. Foul from behind. Thompson had him footed, and they had Billy Vance coming in from behind.
Not a bad play when you don't let him pick it up and also get the 2 points, because Kemp's only a 55% free throw shooter. Vance coming in from behind. Thompson.
Billy Vance coming in from behind.
Not a bad play when you don't let him take it up and also get the 2 points, because Kemp's only a 55% free throw shooter. Vance coming in from behind. Thompson's very careful that he doesn't make the contact. He's just standing there with his arms in the air, and Vance makes the contact.
In 4 years at Concord High School, Sean Kemp has won 85 games and lost 18.
He is, during this tournament, which began back on the 29th of February, averaged 29 points and 15 rebounds per double dip there. Now we're just inside 4 minutes to go in the first half. Tampa's not a particularly good free throw shooter, as you might suspect, 55%. 21-15 lead for the Muncie Central Bearcats. Three-pointer. Rolls across the rim. Kemp had it momentarily, lost it, and went to get it again. Bearcats have won 7 state titles. Nobody's won that many. They'd like to add one more to the trophy case at Muncie Central High School. 3.5 minutes to go on the half. Good pass from Bill Mutz to Sean Kemp. Pretty good move against the zone. Put Mutz at a high post. And you have to commit yourself defensively, and it's pretty tough to take anybody off that baseline when you got the big Kemp behind you.
Kemp runs the baseline well, Tommy. He just doesn't go down there and stand.
Good defensive play by Kemp. Vance knew he was in trouble, but had already committed himself and had no other choice. Well, he thought he might fake, but it doesn't make any difference if you get him off his feet. He's still going to be tall enough to do some harm regardless.
Inside 3 minutes and a half. Johnson, pretty good ball handler. One he made out there is Steve Larkin, number 24. Here's Johnson again, only a sophomore. Concord starts 2 sophomores and 3 centers. Kemp just muscles his way in and lays it off the glass. 14 points for Sean, and the lead, which was 7 a couple of minutes ago, is now down to 2 at 21-19. Victor Young. Here's Winningham in the corner. Rebounded by Long, and he got it.
Well, Sam was going to try and outfox him that time and see if he would leave his feet, and he had to get back away from the big man in order to even get the shot off.
Some of the mind games are interesting, Tom.
That's right.
They really are.
He had a nice touch. Say, if you're Coach Bill Harrell, I don't know what you say in those situations. When you can't keep the man away from the board, he's going to get the pass up there, you're in real trouble.
1:54 to play in the half. 23-21, Muncie Central clings to a 2-point lead. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell. Seen some really Tom Heschen and Hillier Gates up and down the floor basketball today.
Very interesting ball game. The Sean Kemp situation, along with Chandler Thompson, Sam Long. A lot of techniques, and really at times it doesn't look like a high school game at all.
It does not.
Well, I was just thinking of all the state tournaments we've seen combined right here. I don't know that I've seen anything in a half that has had so much action right at the rim as this first half of play here this evening.
Concord's made a change in the lineup. Number 50, 6-foot senior Ryan Sumrack, with a 2.5 point per game average, is in the lineup. Here's the three-pointer by Victor Young. First three-pointer of the ball game.
Now, that's almost something you disdain in a contest like this, but that may loosen things up a little bit, and Victor's very capable out there.
If you have not seen any high school basketball this year, the three-point line is 19 feet 9 inches in the center of the hoop. There's the turnaround shot inside by Bill Mutz, and he joins the scoring column for the first time.
That shows you what kind of a chess game it is when they come in with a zone that the Bearcats have had, put Mutz in the middle, and you have to come up after him with Kemp behind, and Mutz is going to hit the shot.
Well, Sam Long had just enough time to turn around and realize that Kemp was about 3 or 4 feet away and couldn't get to him, and 12th in his 20th point of the ball game. This is from a guy who went 1-for-10 in the earlier game today. Johnson. All of a sudden, Tom, it's 3-point time.
Well, Jamar's very capable. Fine shooter, fine athlete.
And only a sophomore.
That white line is the same distance that the colleges use. The outside dark line is the pro line for the Indiana Pacers. And the rest of the NBA squads have come in. Now a chance to tie. The ball game has been tied 5 different times. At 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. The biggest lead of the night for Concord was 2. And Muncie Central's had as many as 7 points in their favor on the scoreboard. Now it's down to a 2-point ball game in the final seconds of the first half.
Well, this is a situation you want to take the shot with enough time and let the big man slam it home or tip it in for you. But he's out on the floor.
Johnson missing. Rebound, and that's it. But a great first half of basketball. We got a tremendous halftime ceremony coming up. Please. State final medals will be presented to Bedford North Lawrence and Hammond Bishop Knoll, and we'll be back with all that stuff for you in just a second or so here. Let's take a pause. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. As part of the great tradition here at Market Square Arena, at halftime of the state finals championship game, the state final medals are presented to the two teams who were here and did not make it into this championship game, the Bedford North Lawrence Stars and the Hammond Knoll Ball Club. Let's go across the floor again to Scott Gray.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we direct your attention to the north side of the court in front of the scorer's table for the presentation of awards to the two state finalist teams eliminated this afternoon. Presenting the state finalist medals to members of Bedford North Lawrence High School will be Bill Shepherd and Ed Pittman, along with Jacob Delagrange, members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. First, presenting a finalist medal to Damon Bailey. Troy Boshears. Brent Byrer. Derek Klaus. Eric Flynn. Troy Eicher. Jimmy Jones. Greg Mayuran. Brad Knoll. Greg Pittman. Jay Ritter. Jeff Spear. Manager Joe Wells. Assistant coach Mark Matthews. Head coach Dan Bush. Athletic director Ray Manis. And principal Stephen Saylor. And now, making the presentation of finalist medals to members of Hammond Bishop Knoll High School will be Paul Rommelman and Lanny Parker, members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. First, Russ Marcinek. Aaron Mercer. Tim Reed. Adam Paytai. Austin Bank. Nike McCoy. Odestris McCoy. Damon Scheit. James Bratke. Kevin Phobos. Robert Radziwicki. Terry Austin. Manager Ronald Glass. Assistant coach Ron Luketic. Athletic director Jerry Lassick. Head coach Jack Gaber. And principal Dr. John M. Shields. Ladies and gentlemen, let's recognize these two outstanding schools for their participation in the state final.
Well, Tom, it's an honor just to be here, and I'm sure the folks and the fans of the Bedford North Lawrence and the Hammond Bishop Noel ball clubs are just as proud of their team as if they were playing in this title game tonight, and we salute them.
Well, they should be proud. The kids really acquitted themselves very well. They played hard, and they played, very tough basketball, very much under control, very much poised, just fine, well-coached ball clubs.
We'll take a little break here finally. Let's pause now for these messages.
Former Assistant Commissioner Sherman Keller. I'd like to recognize these two outstanding men at this time.
Halftime score, Muncie Central by 2. They're being led in scoring by Sam Long. He has a season high of 22. He has 20 points and 8 rebounds in this ball game tonight. Concord being led by Sean Kemp, who's had seven rebounds to go along with the 16 points. So it's really been the Sam Long, Sean Kemp show so far tonight. But there's a lot more activity to come and a lot more time to get the job done in. We'll take a quick break one more time. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Jerry Baker, Hilliard Gates, Tom Eschen, back live, Market Square Arena. We've gone through the halftime ceremonies, and here are some halftime numbers for you, Tom.
Well, 50% from the field for the Bearcats. Concord, obviously, not hitting quite as many of the rebounds, 18 to 13, Muncie Central up there. But the Bearcats also lead in turnovers, 11 to 7. They really haven't forced Concord to make many mistakes, and Concord certainly, with some other statistics that aren't showing right there, a little bit on the negative side, still in the ball game by only 2, trailing at the moment 28-26.
Both ball clubs have returned to the floor at Market Square Arena, getting set for the second half. After the first quarter, it was Muncie Central by 6, 18-12. They kicked the lead to 7 in the second quarter, but at halftime up by only 2, 28-26. We'll return with the second half for you in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell. Here are some comparative numbers with Big Sean Kemp and Sam Long. I would not have anticipated comparing those two guys the way that Sam had played this afternoon, but he's having a dynamite night. There are a group of young men, the 1943 Lebanon High School basketball team. 1943, they were state runners-up that year, losing to Central to Fort Wayne by 5 points. And as they have done every 5 years since they were runners-up, they have gathered together at one of the members' houses. Tonight, they're at John Donaldson's house in Lebanon and watching our ball game, and we wish them well. And it's nice to know that so many of them are still active and interested in this great game of high school basketball. Nice to have you with us, gentlemen. Second half gets underway with Concord's Gerard Johnson tying it up at 28.
Got a nice pick there from Bill Mutch. Went right around, took the nice jump shot.
Last time the ball game was tied was way back at 10. Just underway, ball batted free, and will belong to the Muncie Central Bearcats. Their record is 27-1. And their average winning margin this year has been 17.5 points per ball game. They have not had a number of very tight games, 12 wins over 20, 4 over 30, and a couple over 40. And we mentioned their singular loss was to Richmond in overtime. 30 seconds into the second half, Chandler Thompson in trouble on the baseline, forced his way up and got it anyway. Tom, good move.
Well, he really did. He used his body very well to shield the ball on his way up. And then at that point in time, his strength took care of him, and Kemp couldn't get to it.
Thompson had a 32-point, 13-rebound afternoon in the victory over Bedford North Lawrence. He was shut out in the second quarter tonight. He comes up with his first two here in the third.
Now Concord had the same little move that time, only they came to the left side of the key, and Mutch set the pick for Johnson. He missed it, and Sharp couldn't get the rebound basket to go in.
Nice quick move by Sean Kemp. He plays over your shoulder and cheats just a little bit around the edge. And those big, long arms, which, by the way, are 42 inches. He had a 42-inch sleeve length and size 16 shoes. Good pass by Kemp, getting it inside to Bill Munch. For those who didn't catch the afternoon game, Tom, one of the things that Kemp does so well, is besides scoring and rebounding, is he sees the open man very well.
Well, he had, I think, four or five assists this afternoon.
Here's a foul that should be on Sean. That'll be number one on him. And again, the quickness of Chandler Thompson is about the key to offsetting the height of big Sean Kemp.
Well, I think the fact that they got Thompson through the first half without committing any fouls. Here we're going to see the play down here that Kemp gets the assist. There's Much standing right back here behind Thompson all alone, laid it in. But Thompson had no fouls. Kemp had no fouls at halftime, so Bill Harrell feels now he can take Thompson right at the big man and see what happens.
Thompson didn't get into the second quarter too heavily.
No, he really was not a part of the offense at that point.
Chandler Thompson in the first half was only 2 out of 5 from the floor. Now, those came early in the first quarter. So Thompson has equaled his entire first half outfit in the first minute and 40 seconds of the second half. He has 8 points so far. He's carrying a 22-3 scoring average. Good pressure being employed by Victor Young. Larkin got around it. Jamar Johnson got around it. Now deep in the right corner down there is Macy O'Sharp. And good position on the rebound by Sam Long, who's just having an all-American night here in this title game. Well, these are kind of nice when you're a kid playing in your backyard you dream about. Kemp on the defense that time against Chandler Thompson. What's good for the goose is good for the gander, I guess, because Chandler got him earlier in the contest.
Well, we may have some things to look forward to if they're going to go one-on-one here in this half.
What a great touch for a big guy, Tom.
Kemp shows you he doesn't have to do his work inside. He can step out there and very deftly hit that hoop.
High ball game again at 32, third tie in the second half, eighth tie of the ball game. Here's Winningham missing. Rebound tipped up once, won't go. Loose on the floor and saved and underhanded back in by Sean Kemp. So nonchalant, Bill Harrell didn't agree with it. But maybe there was a foul or a baseline violation, but no call. A steal by Victor Young and lost out of bounds by Victor Young. Oh, I love watching Kemp play, Tom. And once in a while, you get the feeling like, it's just, let's just see what I can do here. Let's see if I can make the windmill motion or something like that. Goes and tracks down the rebound, underhands and directs traffic now.
He has been kind of, you said, directing the traffic out there. He knows where the ball has to be in order to make the inside pass, which they did right there.
Well, the foul was prior to the shot, and it's going to be on Kemp. And that'll be number two on the big guy.
Here's the play that Jerry indicated that Bill Harrell didn't like. He thought he might have been on the in line, and it looked like he might have had the shoe up there. I don't know if he stepped on it or not.
Foul was on, Sean. That's two.
Yeah, Kemp has just committed his second foul, and let's see. He's going to line up in there with Chandler Thompson. When they get down the court, you're going to see Thompson right there at the free throw line and Kemp right behind him.
Much reached in and didn't get the job done, so it is saved on the baseline. Here's Winningham. Yes, and Chris Winningham gets his first bucket, his third point of the night. And I'll tell you what caused that, because there was quickness in the corner down there, and Kemp went down to help out. When he did, he left the baseline area right underneath the hoop all by itself. Nobody there. Here is Young on the steal. Victor going one-on-one, got the hoop. What a great play by Victor Young. He was going one-on-one on Steve Larkin that time and just flat beat him.
Well, I thought maybe Larkin would move over and force him to use his right hand. And he let him go to the left side, and Young made it easy.
4-point lead now. 7-point has been the biggest margin for Muncie Central. And a 3-second lane violation. I think it might be Much that got caught in there that time. Another turnover. Almost halfway through the third quarter. There's still nothing been decided in this ball game.
Still man to man. There it is. Going to call a travel on Thompson.
Tom, I think we expected turnovers in this kind of a ball game, especially at the pace they were going. You just simply can't play and play without turning the ball over at that level.
Well, Muncie Central had 11 in the first half to Concord 7, and each team has picked up a few here in the third period.
Now we're halfway through this third period, and a walking violation out high by Jamar Johnson. Got himself turned around. The defense was good on his back, and he tried to lob that alley-oop pass inside the camp, and he'd already drug his pivot foot.
Well, they got much over on Long's side at the moment, and we'll see if that means anything. There's a pass that Whittingham just lets get through his hand.
Into Jamar Johnson. Concord back with the basketball. They're down by four, 36-32. They can't get the roll. Kemp can't get the tip, and a foul maybe on Johnson from behind. Or Thompson, I should say. Chandler Thompson will pick up number one. And we'll send for 44.
Well, when this shot was up, you knew that if it didn't go in, Kemp was in good position to put it back up, which you see right there. And I don't know how that one kept from going in, but you see Thompson's arm coming in from behind and committing the foul.
Here's Kemp back to live action from deep in the corner. Kemp now with 20 points. Sean, a 23-4 score, had 19 in the victory over Havin Bishop Knoll. And he has pulled Concord to within two. And an excellent move by Chandler Thompson. Thompson with 10, six of them here in this quarter. 3:10 to play, period three. Concord in green looking for their first ever state title and a record of 29-0. And becoming only the seventh team in the state ever to win a state title undefeated. Thompson can't get it. Whittingham goes after it. It's picked up instead by Concord. Much muscles it up and missed it. Here is Kemp, and he will get the hoop and go to the line. Foul is on Chandler Thompson. That's two on him.
That was a big offensive sequence right there for Concord. They had an opportunity to lose that ball several times on a missed shot or a missed tip. Here's the replay. Here's Kemp. Gets it. And Chandler Thompson, Jerry, commits the foul.
Chandler with a couple of personal fouls, and Kemp goes to the stripe. A 55% free throw shooter. He's 0 for 2. Now 3. But Concord gets the rebound, and Thompson finally rips it out of there on the miss by Steve Larkin.
Took the Bearcats a while to get that one away from their defensive end. They were down there for an eternity.
Here is Thompson turning. I think Long or Kemp got a piece of it, and it's going to go in anyway. Sean Kemp with number three, Chandler Thompson with the bucket, and he'll go to the charity stripe where he's a 73% shooter.
Well, he had to put the ball almost straight up in the air.
Kemp wants to come out of the ball game. He just signaled to Jim Hahn he wants to come out.
Yeah, he wants to take a little break, and he's going to have Chris Bailey replace Big Sean. We mentioned before the ball game, the number of minutes that maybe Kemp or Thompson has to spend on the bench might be an edge, and we'll see how long he's going to be there with 2:32 to go in this quarter.
And if you're a first-time tuner in, of course, you do play two games in one day, and that is not an easy task for anybody. And especially the team that played in the second ball game, which in this case was Concord. A break with 2:32 to play, 41-36 Muncie Central. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. Muncie Central has outscored Concord 9-4 over the last couple of minutes to take that lead to 41-36 as you gaze into this 59th consecutive sellout crowd for the state finals here at third quarter field goal numbers.
Well, Concord continues to get the more shots at the hoop, but the shooting percentage hasn't picked up at all. And we're going to have Sean Kemp still on the bench. I thought with a timeout coming right there that Jim Hahn might decide to put him back in, but he's still on the bench.
Good full court pressure for the Bearcats of Muncie Central High School. Their defense allowed only 56 points per game in this tournament so far. They got an open man up court, Victor Young, but they can't get it to him. The ball is kicked away. It will belong to Muncie Central.
I have an idea that Bill Harrell might have put that press on with the fact that Kemp on the bench, they don't have the big man to release it to, and decide this is the time to go full court.
Good idea. All by himself on that right side and knocking it home is Billy Vance. Now, Vance has not been heard from much in this game. First 2 points, as a matter of fact. He came off the bench earlier today and hit 6 out of 8 from the field and 3 out of 4 from the free throw line. He had a 15-point afternoon. Three-pointer was on the way by Johnson. And Jamar has his second three-pointer of this contest and 11 points in the game. And it's 43-39, just like that, off the foot of Sam Long. And here comes the big guy back again. Sean Kemp comes in, as does Ryan Sumrack.
Well, on the clock, he only had, 12 and 32, 44 seconds on the bench. So timeout period in there, give him a sufficient rest.
He got a couple of minutes. Yeah.
That's right. Camp is playing out high. There's the ball out there. Had it lost away momentarily. Steve Larkin was to get it. Minute and a half to go, third quarter. Three-pointer again by Johnson, this time short, and the rebound by Sam Long. For Sam Long, that's his 12th rebound of the game to go along with 20 points, and he's been shut out scoring-wise in the period. Thompson is cut from behind by Kemp. No foul. Much to the chagrin of the Muncie Central fans, now the personal foul on Ryan Sumrak. What a great move by Kemp. Both Kemp and Thompson, Tom Heschen, can literally come from nowhere to stop your offense.
Well, you're going to see where they come from here. Comes Kemp down from the baseline, and boy, Thompson and Kemp are both experiencing things tonight they haven't had to go against all season.
A minute and 5 seconds to go in this third period. 43-39, Muncie Central with the lead. They have not trailed since they were down by a couple of points off and on throughout the first quarter. It was 18-12 Muncie Central after one period. 28-26 the Bearcats at halftime, and they're up now 43-39 in the final 45 seconds of this third quarter.
Well, a four-point lead. Bill Harrell just wants to use some talk right here and go into that final period up by at least four. Jim Hahn immediately changed his defense to a little half-court zone situation so they don't get themselves in a position where they have a seam to let a man get a three-point shot, maybe.
Thompson, by the way, if you're wondering, is sitting very quietly at the very top of your screen. Free throw line extended. Now we're down to 10 seconds. Here is Winningham for three. Rebound by Long. Yes! Sam Long with a sensational rebound and a putback.
You know, sometimes you think maybe you're supposed to win when you bring a Billy Vance in this afternoon, and Billy averaging maybe a couple of points a game gets 15, and Sam Long gets 2 points this afternoon. Watch this rebound by Long. And he had 20 at halftime and gets another basket right there and is going to be at the free throw line. Last week, Victor Young had 24 in one of the semi-state games and didn't score in the other.
Sam Long had 23 points in the semi-state with 11 in one game and 12 in the other. So far today, Tommy's had 2 points, and now he's on with 22 in the night game.
Not much activity at the free throw line, as you see in the stats there.
23 now for Sam Long. 5 seconds, four. Here is Sean Kemp with a three-pointer that all catches the front of the rim, and that's the end of three periods. Eight more minutes to go for the state championship, 46-39, Muncie Central. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell. Concord Minutemen have only four players who have scored in this ball game. Jamar Johnson with 11, Sean Kemp with 22, Macy O'Sharp with 2, Bill Mutt with 4. Steve Larkin has not scored. Muncie Central's Sam Long has 23. 13 for Chandler Thompson, 5 for Victor Young, 3 for Chris Winningham. The only player on either ball club to come off the bench and score is Billy Vance, who has a couple of points. 46-39 is your score. Final 8 minutes of the contest. Sam Long, with those 23 points, also has 15 rebounds. John Osler, who's keeping our stats for us tonight, indicates, so he's having himself just a dynamite ball game. Final period underway. Here's Long, and he walked with the basketball. One of the few mistakes he's made so far in this contest.
Well, it is, but that's another one of those that's forced. The fact that Sean Kemp was the defender inside, and Sam couldn't release the ball toward the hoop without getting it blocked, and he took steps.
Concord in a rather precarious situation. They're down by 7. That's their biggest deficit, equals their biggest deficit. And I got a feeling right now that if Muncie Central, Tom, gets any kind of a lead, they're going to play a little bit of keep away here and eat some of that clock. Here's Thompson, trying to get two more, and he does. Thompson had 4 points at halftime. He added 9 in the third quarter. Now he has 15. So Chandler Thompson right on track to have another great basketball game tonight. 9-point lead is the biggest for Muncie Central, and they'll get the ball again on the turnover. Substitution for Concord coming back into the ball game. 44, Macy O'Sharp. Out of the lineup is Ryan Sumrak.
Full court press now. Jim Hahn's going to have the Minutemen go after him all over.
and the Bearcats get it down quickly into the offensive court. And they get the turnover. Maceo Sharp forcing it. Concord Ball Club shooting from outside. They're not in the range where they need the three-pointers right now. Good strong move to the hoop. The tap up will follow by Victor Young. Vance missed it, but Young was Johnny on the spot, and Victor's got his 7 point. And the lead goes to 50-39. And Muncie Central has the lead, and Concord announcer will take one also. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Final 6 minutes and 46 seconds of this basketball game for the state championship in Indiana. Muncie Central Bearcats, 27-1, ranked number one in the state. Concord Minutemen, ranked number two, unbeaten in 28 ball games. They tell us the first time ever for the championship Hilliard Gates that the numbers one and two teams are going at each other.
And we've had a rather sterling duel.
We really have. It's the kind of a ball game you'd expect from the two top teams in the Hoosier land.
This is an important possession for the Minutemen.
They got the bucket. Jamar Johnson now with 13. Only two Concord Minutemen in double figures. Johnson and Sean Kemp. And the turnover gives Concord the basketball again. They go back underneath, and that lob pass is working brilliantly. That's Maceo Sharp with his second field goal. The first came back in the first half. Long again. Not this time. Tipped up and in. I believe Chandler Thompson will get credit for it. And that'll be 17 points for him.
They're going to give that basket to Vance.
All right.
Could have gone either way.
They'll take it off of Thompson and give it to Vance for his 4th point. Off of John Kemp and out of bounds to Muncie Central.
Hilliard, that's what I thought they might go to a little earlier in that last quarter, is to get the ball back up to Kemp like they did early in the ball game.
Well, I was waiting for it.
Inside 6 minutes. Full court pressure now by Concord. Muncie Central handles it easily. Chandler Thompson brings it across the line. He had an open man on the other side that time. Billy Vance did not opt to go that way. Here's Winningham. Out of Victor Young. Now we're playing belly-to-belly defense right now as Concord comes out and puts the pressure on. They trap in the far corner. And somehow Vance gets out of there with it. Inside, Chandler Thompson saw the... Saw the big hawk and almost pulled off a reverse layup inside. But Kemp is just simply too much. Tom, his arms just cover the whole area down there.
Well, that was. Thompson nearly made a good move, but Kemp certainly is a dynamite performer. Look at this by Billy Vance.
Half a dozen by Billy. The baseball pass was by Chandler Thompson, and it's 54-43. Back to the 11-point lead, the biggest of the ball game for Muncie Central. They have led since about three-quarters of the way through the first period. The foul on the elbow on Billy Vance. And that time, Sean Kemp was a long way from the hoop. We're getting a quick huddle now around head coach Jim Hahn as they prepare to go to the free throw line.
I would think that maybe they want to see, well, here we go. We're going to see Vance come back here. In the meantime, a timeout's going to be called over there. And 11-point ball game with 5 minutes to go, Jerry.
Let's pause for these messages. There's just no discipline. There just seems to be no discipline right now. Did you hear that?
Defense by Kemp.
Okay. I was being facetious. We can hear real well out here. Dave.
11-point lead for Muncie Central. Here's this nearly sensational play by Chandler Thompson.
Well, he sees he's going to be blocked on that side, and he comes back and couldn't get it up above the rim. But he read it well, and Kemp, of course, very effective as the defender, as he has been throughout the season.
Three-time Parade Magazine All-American, Sean Kemp at the free throw stripe. He's not going to win many All-American honors from that stripe. He's a 55% shooter. He was 7 for 11 in the afternoon victory, but tonight he is 0 for 4. 23 points now for the big 6'11 senior who's headed for the University of Kentucky. Winningham could not track down the inbounds pass, and Concord's got it again with almost 5 minutes to go. This ballgame is a long way from being over.
See what Jim Hahn set up the last time out offensively. They need to get themselves a little better organized. There they took a good shot. Larkin, who hasn't been hurt from tonight, that's his first hoop.
Bearcats waste no time getting it up court. Dropped off by Thompson, got it inside to Sam Long. Sam has 25 points and 15 rebounds. He had 7 boards in the third quarter alone.
Concord in a position now they cannot afford to trade baskets.
10-point lead, Muncie Central, blocked by Thompson and picked up by Concord again. Here is Larkin, penetration inside, knocked it away. Here is Winningham. Chris looking for his first hoop is clobbered from behind, and a pretty smart move on his part, Tom.
He knew the big man was coming from behind, and he did one very basic thing. You keep your body between the defender and the ball, and he has to come over me to get there, and that's just what he did.
He had no chance at all of getting the layup because he knew that Kemp was going to be there. Here's the defensive play by Winningham at the other end, as a matter of fact. Then Thompson gets it and just zips it out of there.
Now here comes Winningham. Now if he shoots the ball, Kemp's going to put it right up on the board for him or knock it in the crowd. He slowed down, and he hits the free throw.
It's only his fourth point. He had only 12 points in the two games last week in the semi-state. He did not score earlier today, but he's the kind of a kid, Tom Hessian, you love to have on your ball club. He's not going to score many points, but he's the quarterback of the club.
Very competitive, and he's going to be a worn-out kid before this day ends.
He was assigned Damon Bailey, the sophomore sensation of the afternoon game with Bedford North Lawrence. Bailey scored his points, but did not shoot well on 8 out of 21. Out of bounds to Muncie Central.
Well, Long, Winningham, and Thompson, the three Muncie Central players, have had no minutes on the bench today. They have played all 32 this afternoon and every minute here tonight.
Victor Young, penetration, dishes off inside, hammered from behind, and that may be Kim's first fifth personal foul. He's gone. Well, he put on quite a show. He'll leave the ball game with 23 points. And 13 rebounds.
Nice pass coming from Young. There you see Vance send it up, and Kemp comes from behind, and he gets a nice hand. He has really electrified the crowd
here today.
People have really appreciated the effort, and also they appreciate the opportunity to watch him play, and I hope you that are viewing have had the same thrill in seeing this gentleman play Indiana basketball.
Oh, I'll tell you something. He moved up that career ladder, as we told you, past Steve Alford into number 9 on the career scoring list. And I am very impressed by the way he handles himself, not just in scoring and rebounding, but he's a good passer. He sees the floor well, and he runs an offense. I guess you're going to listen to him for 6'11", as big as he is. Vance with a couple of more points as a 6-point fourth period. And now the lead is 59 to 46. That's as big as it has been throughout the entire game. Thompson, baseball pass up court. Here is Billy Vance again, and a foul is called. Vance with two more. And the foul is on Steve Larkin, and the Bearcats of Muncie Central, Tom and Hilliard, have broken this baby wide open.
Well, their bench over there is exuberant. The fans in the stands are going wild on the Muncie side, and they smell number 8.
They won state championships in 28, 31, 51, 52, 63, 78, and 79. Those in 78 and 79 belong to Bill Harrell.
Those eights have been pretty good to him, 28, 78. And they're on their way here in 88.
Vance completes the 3-point play. Billy with a 9-point fourth quarter, and it's 62 to 46. And Vance tears the rebound off on the other side. A 16-point lead in what, Tom, it seems like 5 minutes ago was a 5-point ball game.
Well, Well, this quarter has belonged to Muncie Central. Chandler Thompson, and a great assist from Victor Young. Thompson has 17. So he's got a 49-point day going right now. 3:05 to play. Nice move, Jamar Johnson. Having a good ball game with 15, including a couple of three-pointers. Muncie Central breaks the press with no problem. Well, they get two more points from Billy Vance.
I wonder if Billy Vance throughout the week felt that he was going to see as many minutes on the floor as he has seen today and perform as well as he has.
Boy, it's been Sam Long's show in the first half, and Billy Vance has had a great fourth period after Chandler Thompson had a dynamite third quarter. Thompson takes it away. I don't think we've mentioned that the Bearcats are going without one of their starters, Cedric Van Leer, who averages 14.5 points a ball game. He's got some kind of a virus, a pneumonia or a flu or something, did not even dress this afternoon, is in uniform tonight, but would not play. We were told that before the ball game. So they have a starter sitting on the bench, and they're still going to win and win handily. Munch with six. 66-50 with 2:05 to go. And Bill Harrell is still coaching hard on the far side.
Well, he had some good teams the last few years, but couldn't get here.
Well, he couldn't get out of the sectional. Took him forever to finally win a sectional ball game. When they did, they've gone all the way. Winningham. We mentioned they won this thing seven times. They were runners-up five other times. They've been to the final two a dozen times, and this is going to be their eighth state championship. Sam Long with 27. A minute and a half to go, and they can start celebrating in the great city of Muncie because they have won themselves a state title. 5 second, closely guarded call, I believe.
Yes, it is.
We'll check Sam Long's rebounds in this contest tonight. Sam with 15. Now we'll get some substitutions. For Concord, Chris Bailey is coming back into the lineup.
I think they're going to let Van Leer come out here to say that he played in a state championship.
I think it's marvelous.
He can stand on the floor with the score of what it is and get him on the floor and get a crowd recognition. Pretty much a senior outfit here for the Bearcats.
A minute and 16 seconds to play. Long again, you betcha.
Oh, he's had fun tonight. Another senior.
29 points and 15 rebounds for a 6'4 senior starting forward, Sam Long. Leads as big as it's been. It's 20 points now. We've got three of them back from Jamar Johnson, his third three-pointer.
Jamar's going to compete. He's coming right back and shooting him up, and he has a lot of talent for a young ball player.
Is that on?
Yeah, they're all going to compete for the final 55 seconds. And here is what you just suggested, Tom. This young man coming into the lineup is number 24, Cedric Van Leer. From Muncie Central. He had a 26-point total in the semi-state last week. He was not well enough to play. In fact, he was in the hospital for a couple of days, was he not, Tom?
Yes, he was, and Vance is going out, the player that spelled him. Vance getting hugs all around over on the bench. He had a big day for the Bearcats. And I tell you, look at Vance's numbers coming into this Final Four tournament. And you could see that probably they weren't going to count on him at all. But that didn't mean anything to Bill Harrell. He got him out there, and he played well.
And Don Osler points out, here's the steal, by the way. Here is Chandler Thompson with a 360. These are the first substitutions Bill Harrell has made in the entire ball game. Final 30 seconds. Muncie Central running away with a 74-53 lead. Hagan. Rebound, Bearcats. There's a group of guys you'll see right there on your screen. They want the clock to stop so they can get in the ballgame and say they played in the state championship. 14 seconds to go.
We're going to get Van Leer a shot there.
9 seconds. Looks like the subs are not going to make it. Nope, they're not. Chandler Thompson with four. And another slam jam for Chandler, and that's the ball game.
Number 8 for the Bearcats. And they're enjoying it. Take a look. Hilliard's going to be speaking with some of the participants.
Jim Hahn, Fall Cup, defeated for the first time this year. He did a fine job. Fine young coach.
I got to tell you something, Tom. Of course, I worked a ball game with Bill Harrell last year, so I've gotten to know him. Very smart coach. You look at his lineup, and nothing's going to knock your socks off, with the exception of Chandler Thompson, when you just look at it. But boy, do they play well together. Well coached, fundamentally sound. It's almost a throwback to the days when they were winning those state championships every other year, it seems like.
Well, it is. They never get frantic, and he expresses that feeling on the bench. And consequently, the players seem to always be in control, and they showed that throughout this tournament.
All right, the final score is Muncie Central 76, Concord 53. Stay with us. We'll be back with all the postgame festivities. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. Well, it's a magic moment for the folks in Muncie. 76-53 win. And I don't think Tom Hessian, anybody would have seriously thunk that it would have been a 23-point difference in this ball game tonight. And indeed, it was not through three quarters. It was 46-39.
No, it really wasn't until it got out of hand there at the end, and then that was another situation entirely.
All right, let's pick up the postgame ceremonies again. Here's Scott Gregg.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if we could please have your attention, we would like to present the runner-up medals, game ball, and trophy to the Concord Minutemen. Making the presentation of the runner-up medals will be Jacob Delagrange, principal of New Haven High School, assisted by Bill Shepard, athletic director at Carmel High School, and Ed Pittman, principal of North Harrison High School, all members of the executive committee of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Presenting the first medal to Tom Rector. Next, Jamar Johnson. Steve Larkin. Dwayne Wickey. Todd Hansen. Mike Swanson. John Kemp. Jade Hagan. Maceo Sharp. Ryan Sumrak. Chris Bailey. Bill Much. Athletic Director Dave Price. Junior Varsity Coach Dennis DeLeo. Assistant coach Glenn Swanson. Head coach Jim Hahn. Principal Robert Sutton. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the runner-up trophy to be presented by Jacob Delagrange, a member of the IHSAA Executive Committee. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1988 runner-up, the Concord Minutemen.
the Concord Minutemen finished the season 29-0. We're getting set for the presentation of the Muncie Central Bearcats. This was the sixth straight year that a North Central Conference team was in the Final Four. They've been there 10 of the last 11 years. And, Tom, you had an interesting observation on North Central Conference teams in the tournament here at Market Square Arena.
Not just North Central Conference, more specifically Marion and Muncie Central. This is the 14th state tournament we've had here, and the Marion has won five and Muncie Central three of them.
All right, Hilliard Gates has the coach of Concord, Jim Hahn. Hilliard?
Jim, a tremendous effort here. It just kind of got away toward the end, didn't it?
Well, it did. You know, we had to go to some gambling-type defenses and that. Muncie Central proved that they're very worthy of their number one rating. They deserve all the credit in the world. We had a fantastic season. We have nothing to be ashamed about. We got beat by a very good basketball team here tonight.
And you have a couple of players who'll be back that you can build around.
We do. We're looking forward to next year. We have some players that played very well as underclassmen. We had a 19-1 JV team. So, you know, we're down right now, but we're not out. We'll be back next year.
Good luck, Jim.
Thanks, Hilliard.
Jim Hahn, back to you, Jerry.
At that Concord ball club was number two in the final poll, Hilliard. They were ranked number 18 in the nation by USA Today. Let's go back across now and pick up the introduction of the championship awards to the Muncie Central Bearcats.
We'd like to make the presentation of the championship medals. The championship medals to be presented to Muncie Central High School will be presented by Lenny Parker, principal of Wapahani High School, assisted by Paul Rommelman, the principal of Couts High School, members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. First for the Bearcats, Darryl Barnes. Corey Caldemeyer. Brian Childs. Darryl Barnes. Corey Caldemeyer. Brian Childs. Dwight Jefferson. Sam Long. Chandler Thompson. Billy Vance. Cedric Van Leer. Andy Welchin. Chris Winningham. Alex Wolf. Vic Young. Assistant coach, Joe Schmoltz.
Thank you very much.
Assistant coach, Mike Drew. Head coach, Bill Harrell. Athletic director, Mike.
Well, the victory cigar is not lit, but it's out. For Bill Harrell, his fourth state championship, his third here in Indiana. There's more to come, including the Trester Award. We'll break now. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. And that's what that man right there has just done. Another state championship. The Bearcats finish up 28-1. And Bill Harrell with the victory cigar. First time I ever met him, Tom, was at Hinkle House before a practice session for the semi-state. And I said, which one is Mr. Harrell? And they said, the guy on the scorer's bench with a cigar in his mouth. And by golly, there he was. We're getting set. We're going to pick up the Trester Award winner momentarily. The Muncie Central Bearcats have yet to clear the stand at center of the court at Market Square Arena. Out amongst them somewhere is Hilliard Gates, so we'll keep an eye on Hilliard. And he's sliding in next now to the Bill Harrell, and Maybe we'll get a chance to chat with the victorious coach. Let's go out now to Hilliard Gates. Hilliard?
Bill, I know you want to say hello to some patients. Some fans that are watching tonight. First of all, congratulations, and I'll talk to you as soon as we get the press corps here, because I think this is going to be a tremendous surprise.
Okay, I want to say hello to my father-in-law, Dick Fletcher, in the hospital in Muncie, recovering from an operation. Dick, we won one for you, pal.
Congratulations. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Takes great pride in presenting
now let's pick up
the Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award. The award will be presented this year by Mr. Ed Pittman, principal of North Harrison High School, a member of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee.
When I announce the winner of this award, I would very much like for the young man's parents to come to the platform to share in this moment with their son. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in this sport, and was selected by members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. It gives me a great deal of pleasure to present the 1988 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award in Boys Basketball to Sam Long.
Well, Tom, that's just about a clean sweep. Sam Long had 29 points, 15 rebounds, had a simply outstanding game, and picks up the Trester Award also.
Well, for a senior wrapping up his career, he had just a great championship game. He certainly dictated the first half offensively for the Bearcats, and then to win the Trester Award, why, this young man hasn't had a finer day in his life.
And here come the parents of this 6'4 senior, and it's got to be the proudest moment of their lives to go down on the platform at MSA, stand in front of this crowd and the several folks watching in on television and enjoy the time with him. Hilliard Gates is up alongside Sam. Maybe we can get a comment from Sam while we're waiting for his parents. Hilliard?
Well, we have him. His parents are coming out here. This has been a tremendous surprise and an extremely popular choice. Sam, your parents are going to come here, and I'm going to give you that moment of privacy, but I've got to talk to you as soon as they get up here on the platform. Congratulations, young man. 29 points and the Trester Award. How about that?
This is wonderful. That's all I can say. This is just so great.
Okay, here are your
parents. All right, the parents have now made their way to the platform here in the middle of the Market Square Arena, and oh, what an affectionate hug that is. And Mom gets one in also. We started the ball game with goosebumps, Hilliard, or Tom, with the national anthem, which just as many years as I've been doing that just thrills me. And now we end up with this thrilling moment, which is one of the great moments in all of sport.
Well, there are a lot of fine moments in sports. And, of course, as you indicated, being on the winning team takes care of a lot of those rough spots over the course of seasons and years. And certainly, as a parent, to have your son be involved in this, and, of course, to Sam himself, end of their entire program, this is a great honor.
We're going to move back up to Hilliard Gates and get a comment from this fine Trester Award winner. Hilliard, it's yours.
Sam, your feelings, you won a state championship, you had a great ball game tonight, your parents are here, your friends and fans are here. How do you feel?
This is like a dream come true. I always wanted this.
You really did?
Yes, I did.
Did you watch this tournament on television or come out here and see it in person?
One or the other every year.
That's great. You had a marvelous game tonight. You really came out of the starting blocks shooting and hitting brilliantly.
Well, yes. I know I had a terrible game this morning. I wanted to make up.
No, you didn't have a terrible game. You didn't have as good as you had tonight.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about yourself. You're about 6'4"?
I'm 6'4", 170 pounds, and I also run track.
I know you run track because we televised your track event.
Well, yes, well, I just played a lot of basketball back home, and I guess it paid off.
What is your favorite subject?
Math.
I better stop right there. That was my worst.
What do you want to do now? Go on to college, and what do you want to be, let's say, 10 years down the lane? What do you want to be doing?
One of the best systems analysis ever.
Do you do some of that right now?
Yes, I do.
What is that? Explain that to us.
Well, I'm in computer programming in high school right now. I'm not really sure what a systems analysis does, but I'll learn.
Did you set a computer plan for this game tonight?
No, I didn't.
You could have.
If I could, I would have.
Coming in here this morning, how did you feel your chances were for winning?
I knew we could do it. We were rated number one, and all we had to do was stop Sean Kemp, and we could pull it off, and that's what we did.
Did you play harder tonight because you didn't play so well this morning?
That was one of the keys.
It was a magnificent performance. What are your other hobbies besides sports?
Well, I like collecting music and swimming.
What kind of music?
Rhythm and blues.
What kind of a grade average do you have at Muncie Central?
3.2.
3.2 out of a four? Your favorite subject, then again, is math?
Yes.
And what is your least favorite subject?
I would say social studies.
Will you go out of college now?
Yes.
Have you selected a college?
No, I haven't. I was waiting for this to happen.
This isn't going to hurt it, is it? Where would you like to go? Name one. Where would you like to go?
Well, I'm not really going to pick one particular college, but I always wanted to play for the Big East.
I knew you were intelligent. Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
May I talk to your mother and father?
Yes.
Okay, would you introduce them to the television audience here? Just introduce them, would you please?
My mother, Mrs. Long.
Mrs. Long. Hi, Mrs. Long. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Tell me your feelings here. This is a marvelous young man and a tremendous athlete, but an excellent student.
I'm very happy for him. I think here in Indiana, they offer many, many opportunities for young men, and I'm happy my son has had the privilege of participating in this activity.
Well, I know where he gets his ability to communicate because you do it beautifully.
Thank you so much.
Do you have any other members of the family?
I have two sons. One, Keith Ivan Long, he played for Central, but they didn't make it this far. And I have one, James Michael.
When you came in here today, did you ever think of a championship and then this magnificent award, too?
Well, I tell the truth, I've had the feeling we were going all the way. This is our year.
Not only at Muncie Central, but for the family.
Oh,
you're overwhelmed, and I congratulate you, and I will let you relax. May I talk to your husband, please? Mr. Long, could I talk to you for just a second? Mr. Long, congratulations.
Thank
this
you.
This Thank is you. A tremendous occasion for you. Yes, were you an athlete?
Yes, I was.
Where?
I played football in Birmingham, Alabama, Bethlehem, Alabama. Football at Dunbar High School. Very little basketball. Now and there was strictly football and baseball.
Well, when Sam got to basketball, that was all right with you, wasn't it?
Quite fine. Indiana basketball state.
How long have you lived in the state of Indiana?
I've been in Indiana 33 years.
Well, so your children have been born and raised here,
right.
Sam had a remarkable game tonight. He's had a good season, though.
Yes, he has. I'm proud of him. He had a very good season. He worked hard.
Well,
he went out on the court and basketball court and in the backyard. He disappeared, took a couple hours in diamond and just shoot.
Well,
he's a dedicated kid for basketball.
Can you imagine what he has accomplished here with this magnificent award and this great state championship?
It's hard to believe. It's really, really feels good. I'm glad for him. But I say this, that I drill in one thing. Number one is education. Grades-wise, the number one thing. Basketball is secondary.
Well,
you can't do anything without the education.
Oh, that's a marvelous
philosophy.
That's
the one we talk about. We had a philosophy of the thing. You play basketball, you can bring a bee home. And he worked both ways. He's a tremendous kid. I'm proud of him.
Well, I can tell he has marvelous parents, and that's the beginning of
thank
it.
Thank you.
Congratulations. And
thank you very
you,
much.
Sir.
Thank you.
Best wishes.
Thank you.
And now back to Jerry Baker.
All right, Hilliard, thank you very much. We'll come back to Market Square Arena, continue our post-game ceremonies in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell. Gates is out on the floor at Market Square Arena working his way up to Bill Harrell, the head coach of the Muncie Central Bearcats. Hilliard, are you in a position to talk with the head man right now?
Well, they're just winding up a press conference here, and I'll get Bill in just a moment.
All right.
He's just finishing up.
All right. While we're doing that, why don't we take a look at some stats on this ball game? Our crew has put those together. Gene Cato on the right-hand side of your screen. talking with Mr. Luger, Senator Luger. Here are some numbers.
Well, you see, the shooting statistics, only 38% for Concord to 59 for the Bearcats. Free throws, Concord really only went seven times to the stripe. They were out-rebounded by the Bearcats 35 to 28, and the turnovers virtually even.
Now let's go back out to the floor. Hilliard Gates has Bill Harrell.
Thank you, Jerry. Here is Bill Harrell, and he has had a chance now to get a little relaxation, talk to some of the press and media here. Bill, you've won two in the state of Indiana, one in Kentucky, and you told me yesterday you really wanted this one this year.
You don't mind if I correct you, do you? It makes three. they're all hard. I don't want to lose any of them.
Three, the third one today.
Right? Yes, okay. In Indiana, that's yeah. Right.
You told me yesterday you wanted it badly.
Yeah, this group is sort of a special group. When you go through a year with a group of players and you don't have a single discipline problem, you run them for 2 hours and you say, okay, guys, you look a little winded. Let's go up and run the bleachers for about 10 or 15 minutes. They go up and run the bleachers and they come back. We put our hands in. What are we going to do? We're going to win the state. And I said, well, the way we're working, we got a shot. Our conditioning showed in the second half tonight.
I was going to say, you kind of sparred around a little bit in the first half, and then you kind of took control of the ball game. Was that because of your physical condition?
I think it had a lot to do with it. I think our defensive changes at the half had a lot to do with it. I also think that Concord had a lot to do with it. You know, they were 28-0, Hilliard.
That's right.
That's a pretty good record.
It certainly is. Tell me about Sam Long. He did not play as well this morning as he did tonight. Did you say anything to him, change anything of his thinking?
I think I did. I used to be a pool player a long time ago, and I know if you're scared when you shoot at a ball, you can't make it. So you don't shoot a scared stick. So I had a little conversation with Sam and told him that if you shoot a scared stick, you're not going to hit, Sam. I said, you're our best outside shooter, and you go 1-for-10 because you floated a little bit and you shot a scared stick. I said, go out and have fun. No, this is a game of basketball. You're supposed to enjoy it. Have fun. If you miss it, I'm not going to say anything. I just want you to do your best.
His best, he didn't miss.
Well, that was his best.
29 points. This is your third championship now, 78, 79, and 88. Is this one sweeter than all the others?
Yeah, it is. I'm getting older, you know, and as you get older, people don't think you can perform as well, and I think this will let everybody know that I still know a little bit about the game after not being here for a while.
There has been no doubt, Bill, about your knowing a lot about this game. You had a special fan in the audience this afternoon and tonight.
Yeah, my mother came from Eastern Kentucky with my sister, and she's 86 years old, and I played 4 years of high school basketball, 4 years of college basketball, and I've been coaching 30 years, and today's the first time she ever saw me coach.
Well, that was a great thrill. I saw her sitting in the stands right behind you when we talked to you before the game tonight, and she was just so proud, and she's, I'm sure, even prouder now.
Well, my dad's is 88, and he's been chastising me for about 5 years about getting him a license plate. You know, like we had in 78 and 79.
Right.
Mama said tonight, Dad said the last thing he said was, tell him if I don't get the license plate this year, not to come home.
Bill, good to see you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Hilliard.
Enjoy it, enjoy it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Back to Jerry.
All right, thank you, Hilliard. I thought Tom Heshnot knew all the expressions, but scared stick is a new one on me.
Well, you haven't been a pool player. That's the problem.
I guess. Let's take a break and come back. Hilliard Gates has a special. We'll take the break, then come back, meet one of the Muncie Central Bearcats, or come out there now. All right, we'll take the commercial first. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana.
I'm going to try to go.
Let's meet the man who had 21 points and 8 rebounds to go along with a 32-point, 13-rebound game this afternoon. Here is Chandler Thompson and Hilliard Gates.
That's right, with 53 points for two games. Chandler, this was an absolutely amazing physical performance you put on here today. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You've been doing this, though, pretty regularly in your career, haven't you?
Yeah, I've been trying to.
What are your special preparations for a game like tonight?
Well, I was trying to stop camp, and I'm sure they're trying to stop me and Sam Long and the other players, but it seemed like we came out ahead.
Did Concord change anything for you on the basketball court, or just to go out and play your regular game?
Well, they changed because I was trying to post up, and they had a small guy in front of me and Big Kemp in back of me, and I couldn't post up. So then that's when Sam Long took over, and he's hitting a lot of shots. He's just taking it straight to Kemp, and we wanted to give him the ball. He was asking for it, and we gave it to him.
You put on quite a show right at the end with your 360-degree loops. That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
You ever miss that?
No, I haven't missed one yet.
I don't think you ever will. You're going to Ball State University, I'm told.
Yes.
And that'll be this coming September?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we wish you good luck and have a marvelous collegiate career because your high school performances were amazing. Good luck to you.
Okay, thank you.
Chandler Thompson. Let's talk to Bill Vance,
Bill is over here, and he thundered along in that last quarter. Are you a kind of a late bloomer deciding to go hard in the last period?
Yeah, the last period, I just kind of went strong to the hoop and played hard.
Tell me your feelings about being a state champion.
Too happy to express my feeling right now.
Did you expect it? Did you hope? I know you hoped for it, but did you feel after the afternoon game you were the match of Concord?
Yep, because Concord, they were number two, and they proved to them that they were number two, but they had to come up against us, and we played hard, and they played hard, and we came out with the victory.
What about your buddy Sam Long? Isn't that something?
Sam was outstanding. That's my buddy. He's great.
You know, he uses words that I don't understand, those long words and everything about computers and science. I'm not sure I understand him.
Sometimes I just look at him like he's crazy. I just don't pay attention to him.
Congratulations, young man. Good luck to you. Let's go back to Jerry.
Great interviews with Sam Long. And now let's go back out to the world's popcorn king. Here is Hilliard Gates with the commissioner.
Jerry Baker said you're the world's popcorn king. Is that right, Gene Fitter?
I love my popcorn. I'll say that. I get a little, paid advertisement there if I eat the right brand.
I must ask you about your father. He was injured in an accident earlier this week.
Well, I talked with my sister this afternoon, and they thought possibly he'd had a blood clot, and they'd taken him to surgery, so I'll be going down there later tonight.
Well, let's offer an additional prayer for him tonight.
Well, thank you very much. I know this. He grew up on athletics and was a high school coach, and he's a competitor, and if anyone can overcome the odds, I'm sure he will.
Gene, congratulations. There were some things happened in this tournament I don't think I've ever seen before in high school basketball.
Well, we were discussing over there during the ball game. We think we're going to have to start a new set of stats, and one of those is going to be the greatest number of dunks in a single game, and we might have equaled that, and we had a lot of talent out there on the floor.
You might have to rate those dunks like a dive, the figures that you get for the dive or something like that. But it was an interesting tournament. Sam Long will make a remarkable winner of the Trestor Award.
Yes, I think that was a very popular choice, seemed to be. And, back to those dunks, I think we saw maybe the first 360-degree dunk here tonight, yep. And that adds a lot of excitement.
Well, it was a lot of excitement. At times, this didn't look like a high school game.
Well, a lot of it was played above the rim tonight, and that looks more like college.
Gene, any changes contemplated? Any things you're thinking about?
Well, not a whole lot. We think we've had a great year. They are meeting in Kansas City, and we'll be waiting to see what they do with the basketball rules. We hope they don't make too many changes.
Well, it's a great thrill to be with you with things just as they are. I congratulate you and your wonderful staff and all the people around the state who make up this great association and the fans who support it.
Well, that's certainly true, and don't leave yourself out. The news media does a great job and makes this event what it is.
Thank you, Gene. It's a labor of love. You know that.
Well, thank you.
Best wishes to you and your father. All right, Jerry.
I was just sitting here thinking about this is our last basketball game, but there'll be an all-star game. I wouldn't mind picking an all-star squad, Tom Heschen, out of the four schools that were in here today and go against those Kentucky guys with that outfit.
No, you're going to have a good balance. Front court, back court, shooters, defenders, rebounders. You could do a good job with this bunch today.
Let's take a look at the Muncie Central scoring in this ball game. They were led, as you well know, by Sam Long, the Trestor Award winner, with 29 points and 15 rebounds. And they had two other players in double figures also, Tom, with
Chandler Thompson had 13 points, and we had a 21-point effort, 13 by Billy Vance and 21 by Chandler Thompson. Long hit 14 of 20 from the field. He had 15 rebounds, 5 assists for Vic Young. I think we should point that out, as you see right up there. Vic did a good job. Winningham steady all day. Never did go out, unless he was one of the few that went to the bench at the end of the ball game. He played 32 minutes this afternoon. 35 rebounds for the Bearcats. They out-rebounded their opponents by 7, and they shot 59% tonight. Not too bad.
It was a much closer game than 76-53. People who didn't watch it and didn't really follow were going to say, God, what a blowout. Well, it was to a certain degree, but it was 46-39 after 3, and at that point, still anybody's ball game. But at the end of the game, especially with Sean Kemp fouling out, the Bearcats took over and they just owned the game.
Exactly. From that point on, even though they were beginning to get control of it before he got his fifth foul, I'm speaking of Kemp, when that point came, it simply went one way and one way only.
The leading scorer for Concord, by the way, was Sean Kemp with 23 points, 13 rebounds. He had a half a dozen block shots. And Jamar Johnson came in with 18 points likewise in the ball game tonight. Well, our congratulations to the Bearcats, but also to Concord, Bedford North Lawrence, and Hammond Knoll, Hammond Bishop Knoll. They all deserve special recognition for just winning their way in to this marvelous Final Four. Well, our thanks to our television crew tonight. It's a long, hard day for all of them, and we enjoyed it. It's truly, as Hilliard said, a labor of love. So for Hilliard Gates, for Tom Heshen, this is Jerry Baker saying congratulations to the Muncie Central Bearcats, the winner 76-53 over Concord. They win their eighth state championship. So long from Market Square Arena.
You've been watching another championship event. Your network sponsors have been Milk Promotion Services of Indiana, your Indiana dairy farmer, Farm Bureau Insurance, and the nearly 700 Farm Bureau insurance agents located throughout the state, and Indiana Bell, a member of the Ameritech family of companies, helping you communicate.